competition's a good thing because it lets you know that there's opportunities there. The bad thing is if you're not willing to think outside the box and try different things, and you're just like a one-trick pony and you have competitors and everybody's doing the same thing and nobody changes anything up, that's when it starts to get tough because, you know, with toys or with shoes or with clothing, there's probably only a certain amount of opportunities in that particular area, like at a thrift store. What's going on, everybody? Steve here, Rake and Profit over rakeandprofit.com, coming back to you with another video. And I want to answer a viewer question in this video. And someone was asking, Steve, you know, should I be concerned that I always see competition when I'm out at the thrift store? So if you're selling on eBay or Amazon and you're going to thrift stores like Savers, Goodwill, Salvation Army, mom and pop stores, you know, the simple fact is you're going to come across competition. There's always going to be competitors out there. And if you don't see competitors today, you're going to probably see competitors out there tomorrow. And a lot of people are scared of getting into businesses that have competitors. And even for folks who do, you know, publishing on Amazon Kindle, or they launch private label products, or they start their own products and businesses selling on like Shopify or maybe merch by Amazon. You know, a lot of people, they tend to stay away from like opportunities that have competition. And that's a big mistake, because when you see competitors there, it's kind of like, how do I say it? It's like, if you see the vultures flying around, you know there's meat, right? You know there's opportunity. And a lot of times you want to be in the places where there are competitors because you know that there's opportunities there. It's the times when you're trying to launch a product or you have a new idea or you're trying to launch this business and nobody's doing it, nobody's done it, and you're like, wow, this might be a great opportunity. But a lot of times you don't win by being first to the race. Sometimes it's better to get into an opportunity that's already working, there's people already doing it, and you can come in and use your creativity and imagination to improve and to, you know, maybe do things better, right? To work harder, to think outside the box. And I believe the same applies with reselling as well. If you're going to thrift stores, you know, you could go more often, you can go at different times, you can build relationships. One of the best advantages that you can have as a, you know, reseller, thrifter, eBay, Amazon seller going to thrift stores is to know, you know, about various products. Don't just go there for clothing, but over time, learn about clothing, learn about toys, learn about books, learn about the glassware and the puzzles and the video games and, you know, the vintage items and, you know, computers and all different types of items, because a lot of these resellers that you'll see at the thrift stores, most of them, I would say, like probably over 50%, I'm just pulling a random number out, are one-trick ponies. And they go there and I see the same people circling my thrift stores all the time. You know, you see the guy who's always circling the clothing. You see the, you know, the girl who's over there, you know, looking, you know, at the women's blazers, right? You see, you know, the old man who's just always prowling around the vintage records and the media and stuff, right? I'm just making things up. But when I go to thrift stores, I see the same people going after the same things, which if you're maybe a bookseller and you have a couple booksellers in the area, it stinks. And if they're always going, like, that's competition, like they're taking food off of your plate. But with that being said, there's always ways to find more inventory. And I've talked about this in various videos, depending on, you know, what your niche is and where you live and the competition, you know, there's all different types of opportunities, from thrift stores to consignment stores to pawn shops to retail stores to Facebook Marketplace, Nextdoor app, Craigslist, you know, building relationships with thrift stores, backroom access, libraries. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. So if something's not working particularly well, or there's too much competition with something, I would ask myself, what can I do to gain an advantage over the competition? What's something else that I could learn about? What's a really great opportunity that I have in my area that maybe somebody in Connecticut wouldn't have? And I use this example all the time, but when I was, you know, visiting the Bonafide Hustler in Austin, Texas, or when I visited, you know, College Picker and Rally Roots in Tampa, you know, they have different opportunities than I would have because it's warm all year long. There's a lot of sporting activities and outdoor stuff, and there's a lot of shoe opportunities that maybe I wouldn't have in my area, right? So, you know, competition's a good thing because it lets you know that there's opportunities there. The bad thing is if you're not willing to think outside the box and try different things, and you're just like a one-trick pony and you have competitors and everybody's doing the same thing and nobody changes anything up, that's when it starts to get tough. Because, you know, with toys or with shoes or with clothing, there's probably only a certain amount of opportunities in that particular area, like at a thrift store. Now, the doors will open wide if you start looking at different avenues and auctions and flea markets, right? You don't want to have all your eggs in one basket, but most people, unfortunately, they're scared about competition. They only try one or two things, they give up too soon, and they're not willing to be creative and think outside the box and do things differently. You know, I think it's really important to model success, but I do think as well, it's important to model success, but then ask yourself, how can I improve? How can I do things differently? How can I, you know, gain a competitive advantage over the competition? And that's why I always tell everybody, I tell my friends all the time, I've got a good friend who sells on eBay. I was telling him actually yesterday when we were having a coffee, I said, these skills that you're learning on eBay are gonna translate over to other businesses as well, because he has all these ideas for different businesses. And I know if you're watching this, you may or may not wanna be selling on eBay forever. You might wanna, you know, start your own website or your own product, your own brand, or maybe even a YouTube channel. But these skills that you're learning to think outside the box and be creative and use your imagination to grow your business, they translate to other things. So don't be scared of competition. I would actually encourage it and then ask myself the question, how can I be better than the competition? How can I do things differently? How can I switch things a little bit or improve something a little bit or do something a little bit differently? And a lot of times just making a 1-2% change outside of the norm could bring in 20, 30, 40, 50% more in gains and results just because nobody else is doing that. And most people get comfortable. Most people get comfortable doing the same thing over and over again, and they'd rather make less money doing the same thing without having to exert more energy than having to try something new, take a risk, and possibly fail, right? A lot of it comes down to comfort levels. So don't be worried about competition. Welcome it and push through it. And there's plenty of opportunities out there. The only thing that's gonna hold you back is you. The only thing that's gonna hold me back is me, is, you know, what's in between our ears. It's our mind and our limiting beliefs. So I'm not trying to get all wishy-washy with you, but there's so many opportunities out there. There's people crushing it. You just gotta, you know, keep pushing forward. Okay. So with that being said, if you enjoyed this video, like, comment, subscribe. If you have any advice or feedback for someone who's going through a hard time dealing with competition, they're thinking about quitting, let us know in the comments. We'd love to hear your feedback. But if you enjoyed this video, like, comment, subscribe, and look forward to hearing from you in the comments. Peace.